morning. This is B. Naresh, working as an assistant professor in AEC department. And our lab is electronic devices and circuits. So before start any experiment, first we want to know the basic requirements in our electronic devices and circuits lab. So we require some of the components as well as devices to perform any experiment. So we'll discuss first what are the components are required in our laboratory session and what are the devices are required to start any experiment day.
Normal p-invention diode, and we know that one electrode is represented as anode, another electrode is represented as your cathode. But here we need to identify so which terminal is anode and which terminal is a cathode. For this case, they are representing that. So in this, one silver color coating is there. This silver color coating is represented as your cathode. And another N terminal is represented as your anode. This is your normal p-invention diode. The model number is IN4007. And apart from this, another diode is required. So this component is called as a Zener diode here. So this Zener diode is also contain the two electrodes. One electrode is represented as anode, another electrode is represented as your cathode. For this identification point of view, in the glass coating, one side block color line is there. And this black color coating terminal is indicated as your cathode. Another N terminal is represented as your anode. And apart from this, another component will be required here. So this is called as a transistor. So generally here we are going to use this model number is the BC107. And it is represented as NPN transistor here. And we know that the transistor contains three terminals, emitter, base and a collector. For this identification, and this transistor contains one arrow representation. So this transistor is the one end is represented by an arrow here. So this nearby arrow is represented is notated with the emitter. Middle one is a you come with a clockwise direction from this arrow mark. So nearby arrow is a emitter, middle one is a base, and the next one is your collector terminal. So like this, we need to identify the terminals for this NPN transistor here. And apart from these components, we require some passive components like resistors and capacitors. So these are the some types of the resistors here. These are the some types of the resistors. And in each and every resistor, some color coding is there. Based on the color code, we need to identify the resistance value of your particular component here. Then another component is capacitor here. So this capacitor contains the two terminals. One is a positive polarity terminal, another one is a negative polarity terminal here. And this capacitance value is also represented here. So by using this one, we need to identify the how much capacitance of this capacitor. So apart from these components, we require some devices. And this device is called as a breadboard. And this breadboard is used to construct the circuit according to your circuit diagram here. We need to place the components and we need to connect the circuit according to our configuration here. So if you observe this breadboard, it contains the four rows here. And middle two rows are used for to place the components here. And the top row and the bottom row is specifically designed for to construct the power supplies here. Either that is VCC or a ground potential here. If you want to observe this connection here, so in the back side, the middle two rows are horizontally shorted here. Sorry. The middle two rows are vertically shorted here, and the top row and the bottom row is your horizontally shorted here. So that is the reason. So based on this configuration, we need to construct the circuit by using this breadboard. We need to place the components. If you want to make the node here, in the middle two rows, we need to place the vertical fashion here. And if you want to make the node here, in the top and the bottom row, we need to place the horizontally here. And apart from this, we require some voltmeters as well as your ammeters here in our EDC laboratory here. And this is one ammeter. This is called as a digital ammeter. This device is used to measure the current. So here they are specifying the ratings here, the maximum rating of this device. So here this device rating is a 200 milliamperes. Means that this device produces up to 200 milliamperes. So by using this device, we can measure up to the current is up to 200 milliamperes here. If you want to measure the microamps, again microamps device is also there here. Then another device is your multimeter, digital multimeter here. So it also, they are specifying the voltage, the maximum voltage here. So here this is the, this device contains the maximum is a 20 volts here. By using this device, we can measure the voltage up to 20 volts. Means we can measure the voltage from 0 volts to 20 volts here. And these are the knobs here. We can, this red color indication for positive polarity knob, and the black color is indication for negative polarity of the knob. Then this is the most important in our EDC laboratory. This is called as semiconductor device strainer kit here. This strainer kit itself, it contains one breadboard and one multimeter and one ammeter and two voltage sources here. This RPS here, regulated power supplies here. And these two regulated power supply contain the ratings are 0 to 15 volts DC. This is the DC voltage sources here. It produces the 0 to 15 volts DC output here. And here also another regulated power supply source is there. This device, this is also produces the 0 to 15 volts DC source here. And this is the one digital voltmeter and right side digital ammeter here. And the bottom side, if you want to consider, if you want to use any AC signal here, it is also represented as the AC voltages here. And here internally it contains a step down transformer here, a center tap transformer. So by using the center tap transformer, middle one is 0 volts and the maximum secondary output voltage is here 12 volts. One end is a 12 volt, another end is 12 volts. And for this RPS, it contains one variable knob here. So by using this variable, we can, if you are rotating this knob, it changes the voltages here. So like, so here also, if you are wearing this knob here, it also changes the RPS voltage, but maximum voltage is 0 to 15 volts here. So another device, this device is called as a digital multimeter here. So the name itself, multi, means we can identify the many functionalities here. So by using this digital multimeter, we can measure the resistance and we can measure the voltages in terms of DC, in terms of your AC. Then so to identify the DC voltage and our AC voltage, one knob is there. If you want to measure the AC voltage, this knob should be placed at the AC side. If you want to measure the DC voltages, the knob should be adjusted to DC side here. And this is the power button here. You can switch, if you want to measure any component parameters or voltages or currents, just first switch on this power here. Then we can measure the voltages or currents here. So by using this device, we can measure the DC voltages, AC voltages, as well as your currents here, but they are measuring the specified ratings here. Again, we can also identify, by using this device, we can also identify the transistor type. So we know that the transistors are two types, either PNP transistor or your NPN transistor. So by using this device, we can also measure the type of the transistor is either PNP transistor or your NPN transistor. To observe that voltages or currents, we require these two patch cards here. So one patch card is for positive polarity point of view and one patch card is a common here, that is acts as a ground potential. Thank you. In the next laboratory, we will start the actual experiment here. So that is the first experiment is PN junction diode characteristics.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.